going to dive right in with the questions. First one is for Ignacio. If Don and Debbie the Chicken got a spinoff show, what kind of show would it be? Talk show, musical, cooking show, obviously vegetarian cooking show. And what would it be about?
Well, I've thought about this a lot. I think it would be about what's next after, you know, after the Robinsons, and kind of going back and maybe running into family members that either he never knew, maybe did, and back to the roots and where it all started, and maybe having to face his past.
Back to a kind of chicken and the egg situation, if you
That's
will.
Cool. That was perfect.
So Toby, and also Molly, one of the fandom favorite things and most talked about things are the family dynamics and that relationship between Maureen and John. How did you cultivate that kind of incredible dynamic on and off set?
Well, I think right from the get-go, Molly and I, we talked about them as a couple, and we were like, well, if we don't create a couple that an audience can empathize with and sympathize with, then it's not going to work, because they kind of are the core of the whole thing, you know, their relationship, like it is in any family, you know. And we wanted to make them a relationship that was not patronizing to an audience, so there wasn't some sort of, you know, unattainable ideal. And also we didn't want to make it too dysfunctional, but we wanted it to be dysfunctional enough for people to go, they represent us.
And Ignacio, there is a lot of kind of, you know, thirst, for lack of a better word, on Tumblr for the robot. What's your opinion on that? Why do you think that is?
Man, I don't know. Solitude?
No, he's hot.
Oh yeah, because he's got the thighs and the ass,
yeah,
and the pecs, and he's got that, you know, the arm thing going.
He's empathetic.
He's empathetic, and he's got those turns that are like,
right,
you know, yeah. I get he's tall. You know what I mean? I guess that's hot for some people.
Yeah, you can get lost in his eye.
Yeah.
So Molly, what do you think would happen in an episode where no one's life is in imminent danger?
Can't even imagine. I mean, what would we do? It's such a funny show to make, because, you know, I remember the first time I read it, I was like, this is really fun. It's this great big adventure. And they're, you know, it's these sort of real family dynamics, but set in this sort of extraordinary circumstance. And it's a really fun show to watch. And it is just really hard on my adrenal system to make this show, you know? It's like your body doesn't know that you're not really in danger. And it's the kind of situation where every episode I'm trying to save, you know, my kids from whatever, being eaten by, you know, ancient aliens. So yeah, I don't know what we would do. We could play cards, I guess. Probably just all sleep.
Some serious sleep, yeah.
Basically, yeah. At the end of season 2, Max, who plays Will, he made us all some t-shirts, and I still have mine, and it just says, space is hard, man. And that's how we felt.
Toby, given the same resources and knowledge, how long do you think that you personally would last in the Lost in Space universe?
I'd be dead. I'd be straight away. Straight away.
Oh my God.
I'm hopeless. This is the movies, right? You know, we get to play these heroic characters. The reality is just, you know,
we're all just
this is not, thank goodness, this is not my brand of shampoo.
So Molly, if there was a news show in the Lost in Space universe, who do you think the anchor would be, and what news would they cover first?
I think it's a nude show for a second.
No,
did you think that too? I was like, maybe the robot
show in the Lost in Space universe, who would the anchor be? I think we should make it Penny.
I would like Dr. Smith.
I know
I was gonna say,
but all be lies.
So it'd be a believable news show then.
Yeah
exactly.
And then just have the robot be the weather person. you know what I mean? Yeah, just showing you
storm.
Danger.
I am going to dive right on in with the questions. First one is for Mina. Do you have a favorite Penny one-liner? And did you improv any of her one-liners?
Oh, God.
I love so many of her one-liners. I did improv a lot. The more comfortable I got with the writers, the more I just started saying stuff, I think. I love Bumper Cars, But Where Everybody Dies. I love Never Eating Unagi Again. There are some good ones in season 3 that I cannot say, but I also really enjoy it. Yeah, I'm gonna have to write my own jokes now, and it's hard. I don't know how I'm gonna follow up the writers. Taylor, do you have any headcanons for Judy? A headcanon is kind of something that you think to be true about the character that isn't explicitly stated. It could be like her favorite food is pancakes or something.
That would be so cute if her favorite food was pancakes. She's pretty serious. No, I imagine that, you know, she has a secret life perhaps of like loving Hello Kitty, and she's, you know, journaling every night and being super cute. Nobody knows.
So Max, I heard that you gave the cast t-shirts at the end of the last season that said space is hard.
Yeah, that was kind of a group thing. Yeah. I remember I screen printed, well, Parker got me and my sister to go to a screen printing class in Vancouver. And we were all brainstorming what to screen print on the thing. And we decided to do the front with a robot head. And then on the back, we did space is hard, because that kind of just became a saying throughout the show, because space was so hard. Space was so hard, but so fun.
So Taylor, do you have any favorite Lost in Space ships?
The only one I'm thinking of is like Dawn and Debbie. That's the big one. So yeah, Dawn and Debbie all the way.
Max, can you share a fun fact or anecdote about the making of Lost in Space that you think would surprise fans?
Ignacio got us lost on the side of a mountain once. We almost weren't able to finish filming season 3 because Ignacio decided to take me, my mom, my sister, Zach, Kobe, and Mina. Taylor, you were missing out. I don't know where you were. He said, it'll be an easy hour, 2 hour hike. And so we're walking up the side of this mountain, and we end up like 2 hours in. We're like, Ignacio, where are we? And he goes, we're like halfway up, I think. And he wouldn't admit it, but he definitely got us lost, because it took 5 or 6 hours, and we actually ended up hiking to pretty close to where we would actually film on the mountains in this place called the LSCR. We were pretty close to there, which was not close to where we started. And thank goodness for Mina and Toby, because my mom was not having it, and they made her stay calm for sure.
So Lost in Space Mountain is what we can expect.
Yes, that's Lost in Space season 4, actually. It's a spinoff series where Ignacio gets us lost on the side of the mountain.
Mina, are there any inside joke on set or between the cast that you can share? I feel like the main inside joke is just that Toby and Ignacio specifically, mm-hmm. when you put them together, there's so many things that are said. There's so many jokes, and a lot of them are very much dad jokes. So I think the dad joke was a running theme. We have a lot of stories that are kind of inside jokes. I know Max and I had a scene in season 2 where he was running out of the cockpit after we had talked, and his belt buckle like hooked onto my belt buckle, and he went down, and then I went down, and then the crew started laughing. And this question is for all three of you. Since this is the final season, did you take anything from set after wrap?
No.
Oh, clothes. I took some clothes.
I didn't take anything.
Just memories.
I took memories and clothes.
I think I was the last to leave Vancouver. So I went in and kind of, I took a couple things, but I took some clothes as well. I took Penny's book. I have a couple copies of Penny's book. I may or may not have a couple other things. They could be lost in space somewhere. They could be lost in my apartment, yeah.
I do have the baseball from season 1 that I played catch with the robot with. And there's a department on our show that I think is kind of unique to our show. We call them Team Robot. It's everybody in charge of making the robot who they are. And kind of by the end of the series, I kind of became an honorary member of Team Robot. So I have a signed baseball, signed by all the members of Team Robot.
Oh my God, you know what else I have actually that I found the other day? I don't know if you remember, but there's a scene where Penny's making Will feel better, and she has a tiny peanut that she called Mini Will. I have Mini Will.
No way.
Yeah, I don't know why, but I found Mini Will.